So, ladies and gentlemen, because Hawk had posted, and a lot of you on different forums beat him up over this, I asked him, I said point blank to him, who is Lighthouse? He said, Lighthouse is the command structure, a five-star general, check your homework, boys and girls, that has total control over all the armed forces in the case of martial law. I asked him point blank, how many minutes on the 7th of October, 7th or 9th, I forget which date it was. Believe me, I had 1,000 questions, only so many minutes to get my questions in. I said, how long were we away from the introduction into full-scale declaration of martial law? He said, 2.5 minutes. This person doesn't know Hawk, never heard of Hawk, doesn't, by the way, listen to my radio program. So the thing is, I didn't volunteer the information. I asked him the questions, and he verified it. Now, ladies and gentlemen, basically, this isn't a staff sergeant. This is somebody who's so high up with so many degrees that you can probably guess his grade, and I got to tell you, you got to guess high. But the thing that is astonishing to me in looking at this is the fact of the thing is I've actually said so many times in my heart to the Lord in prayer, and I'm talking about the Lord Jesus Christ. I said, Lord, what does it take? What will it take? What should it take for people to put two and two together? And ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you that my contact, my, if you will, appointment with Destiny said, unless the people turn off the mainstream news and can get as many alternative sources of information and once again begin to process data and make informed decisions on their response ahead of time, he said, most of the country is not only asleep, he said, Steve, they're in a controlled state of being put to sleep. And he said, many of those people who choose not to see what's going on are going to be put to sleep permanently. He said, it physically made him ill. Listen to me. It physically made him ill to consider what's going to be done to Americans under this scenario. He said, just when I thought I could pretty much cope with everything, he said, then things would come up, and the planning is at such an advanced stage. And I did ask him, I said, okay, the big question everybody wants to know of me is, number one, timing, and number two, what will kick it off? I asked him specifically about Russia and China at this point. He said, that comes later. He says, what's going to kick it off is basically a global financial collapse, but it will center in this country. He said the collapse will then spread so quickly, the civil unrest, and he said he thought they would give it at least 3 to 5 days or even longer until the people cried out for the solution to the problem that's being generated. Now, again, you can believe that. Those of you who are praying Christians, I want you to seriously ask the living God if what I'm telling you is accurate. You see, I don't have to worry any longer about whether you believe it or not. I'm speaking to those that have ears to hear and eyes to see. I'm going to take you to probably one of the most important articles that's been written. And I read it a couple times. I posted it a week or so ago. But now it's really coming into total fruition before my eyes. I'm talking about the article that was on News with Views that Greg Evenson had basically printed called Intelligence Briefing for Military and Police Forces. Now, I want you to listen to this. This is critically important. Intelligence comes in two distinct and uniquely critical components. The first is information or intelligence that comes from sources known to you as an investigator or intercepted sources that may not be known to you. The most critical intelligence sector is that of our own discerning creative minds. Together, these two arenas comprise the data mine that gives us a glimpse into the future. Military leaders and police officials know that this future depends solely on how we assess the data and our near-miracle ability to shape outcomes by how we have collectively interpreted all the leads, or you could put information. If we're able to process correctly, the police agency or forward military unit can deploy its forces based on qualified assumptions that have been drawn from the available intelligence and thus strike or defend effectively and efficiently. Using the descriptive breakdown of the role of intelligence, let's project into 2009 and see what type of outcomes we might expect over the next few months concerning the economic and political events here in the United States. Let's begin with what we do know based on existing information and substantiated reports from across the country. Now, ladies and gentlemen, by the way, the gentleman I talked to, I just got to fill this in because I don't want to forget this. He said, I asked him, I said this, so, you got a fair amount of cash stashed. how's that for a blunt? I said, what are you buying? What are you physically buying? What are you physically doing? What are you physically getting ready for? He says, I'm buying all the food I can get. He says, I'm buying all the ammunition for the weapons I know I will need to defend my life and my family's life, and then I'm going for the gold. Which, by the way, obviously he asked me about gold. Going on, let's begin with what we do know, back to Greg Evenson's article, based on existing information and substantiated reports from across the country. The executive branch of government assuming power on 20 January 2009 is comprised of the most socialist mindset since the Roosevelt years. The cabinet and department executives reflect a bias against historical constitutional precepts and are continuing programs that are set on implementing new ones that will devastate the Bill of Rights and, Greg writes, what is left of it. They are viciously against the ownership of personal defense weapons that are morally degenerate and the rabid support of same-sex marriage, abortion, and homosexuality as a civil right, as well as promoters of open borders with Mexico. This hideous and brashly anti-traditional historic America mindset in Washington has completed the destruction of the bridge between our godly heritage and the present-day four-lane interstate journey into oblivion and destruction. I got to tell you something. I don't think anybody's ever said it clearer than that. The only thing I'd say that every car on that four-lane interstate headed into oblivion destruction has got to be going at least 200 mph, miles per hour. Back to Greg. Most of America has ridden this express train to hell while listening to iPods, lost on a cell phone, or addicted to demonically inspired virtual games or the ever-present laptop. Now, ladies and gentlemen, did you ever stop to think the involvement of the intelligence world in creating virtual reality and virtual worlds to keep you from spending time in the real world in order to captivate you, ultimately capture you and destroy you? I want you to ponder that question. Could it be that a lot of the games that are designed are basically designed by companies that have a very heavy financial stake, maybe backdoor financial stake, by the intelligence agencies to get you into the world of virtual reality so you never have to deal or process data, intelligence, and information in the real world? You can stay an avatar in some game so that basically when the knock on the door comes, it's not any longer reality. It's just an episode in your virtual world. Think about that. Family discussions around the dinner table, parent involvement with their children's school and church, horseback camping trips, and Christ-honoring Christmas gathering have given way to illicit sex parties, including preteen homosexual experimentation, encouraged by psychiatrists. Cheating, plagiarism rings in the public schools, gang affiliation record numbers, drug smuggling, and dope dealing in every community in the country. By the way, Greg was a former sheriff. What then does our intelligence tell us? Based on these known facts, we can conclude that America's days as a moral leader of the world is over. Spiritually, we're worse off than the most backward African nation that still worships rocks and trees. We have offended the true God of the universe and are next in line for utter destruction. That fate, I believe, is well underway. And Greg writes this.